عقب الليل والنهار. قال تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. I advise all of us, myself first and foremost, to be pious by keeping a distance between ourselves and the punishment of Allah. And know, may Allah have mercy on us, that the days do not pass without purpose, nor do the years. قال تعالى: أفحسبتم أنما خلقناكم عبثا وأنكم إلينا لا ترجعون. Rather, the days of each day and what we carry on to the final day of judgment, these will be evidence for us or against us on the judgment day. Each day and year is also an ending point in time for us to think and reflect on our performance and consider the rights of Allah and His Ummah. قال تعالى: إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار. I talk to you today about a great fact of Iman. Whoever denies it becomes a kafir. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has advised us to remember it often. However, many of us want to avoid it and escape talking about it. It is the fact of death. قال تعالى: كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وادخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. It is the biggest reality. Every living thing will end. We each have our own time and our days are numbered. In a sudden moment, our soul will leave our body and will be pronounced dead. Brothers and sisters, the notice of this often comes by a sudden call or a message that someone has died. It may be whom we considered in full health and wealth and strength. And in the hadith, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: من اقتراب الساعة أن يرى الهلال قبلا فيقال ليلتين وأن تتخذ المساجد طرقا وأن يظهر موت الفجاءة. As in the hadith of Dawood عليه السلام, when the angel of death came to see him, he asked, "Who are you?" The angel said, "I am the one who is not afraid of the kings and who is not prevented by places and who will not accept any bribe." Dawood said, "Then you are the angel of death." The angel said, "Yes." Dawood said, "You have come to me, but I am not prepared yet." The angel said, "O Dawood, where is so-and-so your relative? And where is so-and-so your neighbors?" Dawood said, "They all died." The angel said, "Isn't that a lesson for you to prepare?" Brothers and sisters, a Muslim recognizes two circumstances. One, when he is in his home and with family and children, living happily and comfort and health, and he is playing, laughing, and enjoying life. The other, when he is sick, weak, and has no treatment or cure for what ails him. قال تعالى: وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد. When the signs of death are upon us, you may be looking at your family and friends, but there is nothing you can do. You may hear, but you cannot speak, and you look all around you at the people who cannot do anything for you. قال تعالى: فلولا إذ بلغت الحرقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون. At this time of death, in the darkness of the grave and the day of judgment, the people are divided in two groups. The first is described in Quran. إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وابشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. Those whom the angels will advise, don't be afraid of what's in front of you, and don't be worried about your family and children. We will take care of you in Akhirah, and we will keep you, will keep your company in the grave and upon judgment day. The second group is the kafirs, who are described in the Quran as وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي غَمَرَاتِ الْمَوْتِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بَاسِطُوا أَيْدِيهِمْ أَخْرِجُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ الْيَوْمَ لَتُجْزَوْنَ عَذَابَ الْهَوْنِ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَقُولُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ غَيْرَ الْحَقِّ وَكُنْتُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِهِ تَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. To those whom the angels will tell, now we will take your soul and we will show you the punishment and humiliation for all of your denial and arrogance. Brothers and sisters, the Prophet has advised us to always remember the killer of all lust. For all who remember it, if they are in hardship, it will become ease, and those in ease will become in hardship. It has been said, he who remembers death often will have three benefits. One, quick repentance, and the second, a satisfied heart, and the third, intensified worship. And he who forgets about death will have three consequences. One, delayed repentance. Second is dissatisfaction with what he has, and the third is the lazy worship. But please realize that remembering death should not mean expressing sadness and crying while continuing any negligent deeds. Rather, remember death should be combined with our fear of bad end. كما في حديث ابن مسعود المتفق عليه يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم فوالله الذي لا إله غيره إن أحدكم لا يعمل بعمل أهل الجنة حتى ما يكون بينه وبينها إلا ذراع فيسبق عليه القول فيعمل بعمل النهار فيدخلها وإن أحدكم لا يعمل بعمل أهل الجنة حتى ما يكون بينه وبينها إلا ذراع فيسبق عليه الكتاب فيعمل بعمل الجنة فيدخلها. روى في الحديث عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت والعاجز من أتبع نفسه وهواها وتمنى على الله الأماني. Brothers and sisters, janazah is the time for those who have minds and vision and the warning for those who have wisdom and thoughts. قال عمر بن عبد العزيز رحمه الله أيها الناس ألا ترون أنكم مجهزون كل يوم غاليا ورائحا إلى الله تضعونه في سبع من الأرض قد توسط التراب وفارق الأحباب وقطع الأسباب. عمر بن العزيز said, O people, did you see that every day you are preparing someone to go to Allah? You put him in 7 feet of land and then cover him with dirt. His loved ones leave him and his strength are gone. وقال ثابت البناني رحمه الله كنا نشهد جنازة فلا نرى إلا مضرقا باكيا ولا ندري من نعزي لكثرة البكاء وإنما كان بكاؤهم على أنفسهم لا على الميت فإذا حملت إلى القبور جنازة فاعلم بأنك بعدها محمول. ثابت said, we used to witness the janazah and we see everyone is crying and we don't know to whom to give aza because of the commotion. And the truth is they were crying for themselves, not for the deceased. If you carry someone to the grave, please remember that you are going to be carried soon. Brothers and sisters, graves are very confined and hard and scary. La ilaha illallah. How will the first night be in the grave when you return to Allah, the judge and the best accountant? قال تعالى وَلَقَدْ جِئْتُمُونَا فُرَادَى كَمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وتركتم ما خولناكم وراء ظهوركم وما نرى معكم شفاعاتكم الذين زعمتم أنهم فيكم شركاء لقد تقطع بينكم وضل عنكم ما كنتم تزعمون. وكان عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه إذا مر على بقر بكى حتى تخضر لحيته من البكاء فقيل له تذكر الجنة والنار ولا تبكي وتبكي من هذا؟ فيقول سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن القبر أول منازل الآخرة فإن نجا منه فما بعده أيسر منه وإن لم ينجو منه فما بعده أشد منه. ما رأيت منظرا قط إلا والقرة أفظع منه. عثمان بن عفان سيد عثمان بن عفان would carry when he would pass by the grave until his beard is wet. So he was asked, why don't you carry when you remember heaven and hell as much as when you do with the grave? He said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the grave is the first step of akhirah. If you survive, then everything else is easier. And if you don't, then everything is harder. I haven't seen any vision as bad as the grave. Brothers and sisters, it is our foreign sharia that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to know our rights to Islam amongst ourselves. Because the Muslim has rights or obligation when he's alive and healthy, and when he is sick, and even after death. فالمتفق على صحته أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال حق المسلم على المسلم خمس: قلب السلام وعيادة المريض واتباع الجنائز وإجابة الدعوة وتشميت العاطس. The third right is to follow the janaza when he dies. Let us give deeper thoughts to these rights and recognize the greatness of Sharia, which made for the complete benefits of the community. So let us discuss the rights of the deceased over us, to pray for him, and the benefit, and the rules, and the wisdom. وَمَنْ يَدْعُ اللَّهَ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. And those who are meant to be good by good, they will be guided to study the religion. The prayer over the deceased Muslim is of appreciation of him, being good to him, and mediation on behalf of Allah's mercy. And it is a great reward for those who prefer the prayer and follow the janazah. The praying of the deceased is fardhu kifaya, meaning that it's obligatory for it to be done. And so as long as some of us do it, the rest are excused. Salat al-janazah has a great reward and raised our ranks. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من شهد الجنازة حتى يصلى عليها فله قراب ومن شهدها حتى تدفن فله قرابان قراب قرابان قال مثل الجبلين العظيمين. ولما سمع ذلك ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال لقد فرطنا في قراريط كثيرة. The Prophet said, he who waits for janaza until they pray gets a reward of qirat, and he who waits until they bury gets qiratan, two qirat. He was asked, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is a qirat? He said, it is as much as a big mountain. When Umar heard that, he said, oh, how many qirats have we missed? Prayers of the deceased brother and sisters has a great effect on the dead. If Allah accept his brother, mediation as per hadith. And Aisha رضي الله عنها قالت قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من ميت يصلي عليه أمة من المسلمين يبلغون مئته كلهم يشفعون له إلا شفعوا فيه. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول ما من رجل مسلم يموت فيقوم على جنازته 40 رجلا لا يشركون بالله شيئا إلا شفعهم الله فيه. By Aisha, the Prophet sallallahu said, there isn't a dead man who prays for him a group of Muslims, numbered 100. All of them mediate for him, except that Allah will accept their mediation. And Ibn Abbas said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu say, there isn't a Muslim who dies and a group of men attend his janazah, numbered 40, who believe in Allah without companions, except Allah will accept their mediation. Salat al-janazah can be performed at any time, except three times, as per the hadith. قال عقبة بن عامر رضي الله عنه ثلاث ساعات كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ينهانا أن نصلي فيهن أو نقبر فيهن موتانا حين تطلع الشمس بازغة حتى ترتفع وحين يقوم قائم الظهيرة حتى تمير الشمس وحين تضيف الشمس الغروب حتى تغرب. عقبة بن عامر said, three times the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prevented us to pray or bury our dead, when the sun rises and when it is noon and when it sets. In Salat al-Janazah, the Imam stands at the head of the deceased man and in the middle of the deceased woman. And it is recommended to have three lines of people in prayer, for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ صَلَّى عَلَيْهِ ذَلَاهُ شُكُوفٍ فَقَدْ أَوْجَرٍ. Whoever prays for him in three lines, Allah accept him. صلاة الجنازة has no ركوع or سجود and could be done in the masjid or in the graveyard, which is different than the regular prayer, in order that people don't think that you are praying to the graves. فاتقوا الله عباد الله وحاسبوا أنفسكم وزنوا أعمالكم قبل أن توزن عليكم حاسبوها المحاسبة المثمرة التي تنتج ندما على المعصية والتقصير وتحولا إلى العمل والإنتاج والتصحيح. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين أمر عباده بالمسارعة إلى الخيرات وتدارك المرضى من الهفوات. Thanks to Allah and praise to Him. He subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded His slaves to rush for good deeds and to rectify our shortcomings. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد عبده ورسوله أفضل البريات القائل خيركم من طال عمره وحسن عمله. Blessings for the Prophet of the best people who said, the best of you is the one who lives long and perform good and perform good deeds. صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Brothers and sisters, this death is a great warning. By Allah, if it was only death, it will be easy. But things are harder and more difficult after that. Think about standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when people are shaking and hearts are pounding, as in the hadith of Abi Hurairah رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مر بقبر فقال من صاحب القبر فقال فلان فقال ركعتان أحب إلى هذا من بقية دنياكم. وفي رواية ركعتان خفيفتان مما تحقرون وتنفلون أحب إلى هذا وتنفلون يزيدها هذا في عمله أحب إليه من بقية دنياكم. Abu Hurairah said, the Prophet ﷺ passed by a grave and asked, whose grave is this? They said, so and so. The Prophet ﷺ said, two rukas is more valuable to this man than all of your dunya. And in another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, two light and quick rukas, which you would neglect, were to be added to this man's life, is more valuable to him than all of your dunya. So, if you consider a sin, remember that the deceased are wishing. Remember what are the deceased are wishing. Remember they are wishing they can do any worship for Allah. So how can you sin? And if you are lazy of any worship, remember that the deceased desire and work hard on your worship and be quick in repentance before your death comes suddenly. قال تعالى أن تقول نفس يا حسرتي على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت لمن الساخرين أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين أو تقول حين ترى العذاب لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين. Brothers and sisters, let us remember how to pray janaza because this is important today. So after we make wudu, we say Allahu Akbar while facing our Qibla and raising our hand and then placing our right hand on our left hand on our chest, as per the hadith عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كبر على جنازة فرفع يديه في أول تكبيرة ووضع اليمنى على اليسرى. Then we silently say أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم and we recite the Fatiha silently as per the hadith عن أبي أمامة رضي الله عنه أنه قال السنة في الصلاة على الجنازة أن يقرأ بأم القرآن مخافة. Remember my dear that you don't do dua al-istiftah as there is no delay for doing it. Then we say Allahu Akbar the second time while raising our hands and then placing our right hand on our left on our chest as per Ibn Umar and Ibn Abbas who reported raising their hands with every Allahu Akbar. And Ibn Umar and Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهم أنهما كانا يرفعان مع التكبيرات كلها. Then we pray for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم by silently saying the shahada, the tashahud. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Then we say الله أكبر a third time, and we make very sincere prayer for the deceased, as per the Prophet's recommendation, صلى الله عليه وسلم, إذا صليتم على الميت فأخلصوا الدعاء. And it is best we make dua as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اللهم اغفر له وارحمه وعافيه واعف عنه وأكرم نزله ووسع مدخله واغسله بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقه من الخطايا كما نقيت الثوب الأبيض من الدنس وأبدله دارا خيرا من داره وأهلا خيرا من أهله وزوجا خيرا من زوجه وأدخله الجنة وأعيذه من عذاب النار ومن عذاب القبر. يا الله forgive him and have mercy on him and make safe and excuse him, be generous in his stay and wind in his entrance and wash him with water and ice and hell and clean him of all sins like you have cleaned the white thobe of all death and replace him with a better house than his house and a family better than his family and a wife better than his wife and place him in Jannah and protect him from the punishment of grave and the punishment of the hellfire. And then we say Allahu Akbar the fourth time and we say Assalamu Alaikum only one time as we turn to the right. If someone does two salams, it is okay. Also, we should explain that if anyone misses the group takbira, then he consider whatever he does as his first takbira. So he will say his first Allahu Akbar, even if the group is on their third or fourth. Then he recite the Fatiha, and then he continue to the second through the fourth as noted. And if anyone misses the salah in the masjid, he can make it at the graveyard, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. Brothers and sisters, Salatul Janazah is a great worship, and there is a lot of rewards, so don't neglect it or miss any. Especially now with the convenience of modern transportation and communication make it easy. When you see more people making the prayer, you will perceive goodness in the people and their adherence to the Sunnah. May Allah accept from all of us and the Muslims. قال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد وارض اللهم عن خلفائه الراشدين وعن أزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين وعن المؤمنين والمؤمنات إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله إن أمرا آخره الموت والمصير إلى هذه القبور لحقيقا أن يسهد في أوله وأن أمرا أوله القبور لحقيقا أن يخاف أمره أن يخاف آخره. نسأل الله أن يجعل قبورنا بعد هذه الدار من خير منازلنا وأن يفسح فيها ضيق ملاحدنا وأن يجعلها روضة من رياض الجنة وأن ينور علينا ظلمتها وينس وحشتنا ويرحم غربتنا إنه سميع قريب مجيب الدعاء. اللهم انزل علينا من بركات السماء وأخرج لنا من خيرات الأرض وبارك لنا في ثمارنا وزروعنا وكل أرزاقنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إني أسألك خير المولج وخير المخرج. بسم الله ولجنا وعلى الله ربنا توكلنا لا إله إلا الله الحليم الكريم. سبحان الله رب العرش العظيم والحمد لله رب العالمين. أسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل إثم. لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا حاجة هي لك رضا إلا قضيتها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك بك نستجير وبرحمتك نستغيث. ألا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا أدنى من ذلك ولا أكثر واصلح لنا شأننا كله يا مصلح شأن المصلحين. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تدع فينا ولا معنا شقيا ولا محروما. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعاء. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
The last line is not straight. Can we make a straight move? Move a little bit up. Can you move a little bit up? Yeah, can you move up there? Go up.
Can somebody tell everybody?
Brother, try to make short lines, whatever you can. And those of you who don't know, we have a Salatul Jamaat of our young brother. Out of Salatul Jamaat, so please join us. Everybody is okay in the back? You have a space? Okay. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. Just squeeze yourself. الله أكبر
الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا ولتسمعن
كنا من الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم ومن الذين أشركوا أذى كثيرا وإن تصبروا وتتقوا فإن ذلك من عزم الأمور. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
We'll be bringing body from this door, so if you can please make some space in this area for the stretcher to come out, the smaller.
Brother Sheikh Tariq, Imam Tariq, please come over here. Imam Tariq, please come.
This one,
yes? Yes,
yes. Since there is no request, will you please come closer to each other?
Muhammad.
We don't have enough space. Alhamdulillah. Come here and please remember in your du'as. Parents of this young man, 19-year-old, is very Italian. We all are touched by his sudden death. It's unbelievable. Make dua for his parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them patience and grant this young gentleman, Jannat al-Firdaus, they are going to bury. Allah make that part of Jannat al-Firdaus.
Assalamu alaikum. We have the father here, the mother is in the sister section, and he had a younger brother and a younger daughter, a younger sister. As you probably already know by now, Waleed, you know, he passed away at 19 years of age. And he was my brother's nephew through his wife. And I had known him personally for about 8 years when he was 11 years old. So, only a few short years later, we are going there to bury him today. This is the reality of life.
I have these bundle things going
down. So, just want to make sure, as his uncle, I'm here to ask you that if he owed anybody anything, if he had borrowed anything, if he had had any card from anyone, please let me know. We'll make sure that his obligations are met, and we make dua that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his good deeds, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive his shortcomings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him maghfira in Jannat al-Firdaus. And may Allah give sabr to his family, his mother, his father, his sister, his brother, and the whole family, inshallah. This is, you know, we all have extended families, you know, we all have friends and all that. But, you know, for me personally, other than my brother and this child's family, and my wife's sister's family, you know, this is the only family I've got. So this makes us think, this makes me think, our priorities. You know, all of us are in similar situations. You know, we have only a few family members, maybe, you know, in this country. So it is time to make sure that we are united, make sure that we remember that we can all meet this end at any time.
How did this speak?
Can you
hear me? Hello there.
Please make straight lines. We don't have to leave too much gap, but please make it straight.
Inshallah, Salatul Janazah, as it was mentioned in the khutbah, four takbirat. The first takbirah we recite Surah Al-Fatiha. The second takbirah we make Salat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Salat al-Ibrahimiyyah. The third takbirah, you make dua, special dua for the deceased, for al-mayyit. And the fourth takbirah, you make dua for his family and for the Muslim ummah, inshaAllah.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Burial is at Silverbrook Cemetery in Wilmington. If you are lost from the funeral procession, please make it there by 3:30, inshallah. Silverbrook Cemetery. It's already 2:00. In about 15-20 minutes, it'll be time for Asr. So, inshallah, we'll leave together after performing Asr, right after the time starts for Asr, inshallah, and then we'll move.
Thank you. How many children do you have? You are the older one, right? Thank you. Prabhupada said to me last night that we believe and we know somehow much of the time. Young people are so young. When they do so many good things and Allah calls them, they remember them. Do you know some such kind of thing? Just find out.
Thank you.
are following the procession, you can take these cards, these placards. These placards, if you display them in your rear view mirror, and there is a red light, you can pass through the red light as long as you are with the procession. You don't have to stop at a red light. But be careful, you know, no need to take any unnecessary risk. We will most probably make sure to turn on your high beam and flashers. So high beam and flashers are also important. Most probably we'll take 95, but they're still looking at the traffic condition. If 95 is not working out, then we'll go through Old Baltimore Pike and Route 13. So those are two possible routes. We'll find out as we leave, inshallah.
If we make a left turn on 7 Church Road, there will be a lot of heavy traffic because they finish everything at that time. So it might be
right there.
Huh?
Oh, you mean
left turn? Right. So what I'm thinking, you know, go here.
They don't have a second.
You sure?
Yes.